Hi there. Many years ago, many, many years ago, there was a young man who discovered that he had a passion for music and a passion for writing music. And the music written by that guy is among the best music that was ever written by humans. Well, by whom else? Most people agree with that nowadays. But then, in the days when that guy lived, a lot of people thought that music of that guy is unreal. It sounds like the devil has his hand in the process of writing that kind of music. I'll just play you a little example of his music, and well, I'll just play it to you. I'll stop it here. You might have recognized that this guy that I was talking about was Johann Sebastian Bach. Repeat that with me. Johann Sebastian Bach. Please make a video about you pronouncing that name. Now, the joke aside. As I said, the guys in his time, most of them were Catholics, and Protestantism was very young, and the Catholics said that music is not from this earth. It must be the devil's work. So you can see that this accusation of playing devil's music is not very new. And in that piece of music that I just played to you, you can already hear this joy of playing with the harmonies and all that stuff. It almost sounds like rock and roll, and personally I say that rock and roll begins with Bach. So we see that the story of making accusations against music that someone doesn't like and saying that this music is from the devil is very old. It didn't start with Elvis. It didn't start with jazz. And I think it even didn't start with Bach. Maybe the old Gnostics, who performed very complicated forms of singing, were also accused of performing devil's music. I don't know, but it's highly, highly likely. Very possible. And nowadays we have a new wave of accusations of playing devil's music, and that are much more than playing devil's music. It's when you search for Lady Gaga and type in Lady Gaga and conspiracy or Lady Gaga and NWO into Google, you will find pages where, and I think you can take other musicians too, Madonna, maybe Prince, I don't know. Search the web if you want to laugh. I think that's a general thing. Search the web if you want to laugh. But if you want to laugh about these conspiracy theories, there are pages where these artists are connected to different aspects of the whole conspiracy circus carnival. And I'm, on the one hand, I'm amazed that these old tricks are still working for some people, and on the other hand, I'm a little disappointed that all these conspiracy dudes don't come up with new motives. They don't have really new ideas. They just copy the old ideas and put them on new people. They exchange the people that they are accusing with the same old accusations. Well, I think this was more like a light episode. And I'll end it once more with saying that wonderful name, Johann Sebastian Bach. Search the web for his music, or buy CDs with Bach. He was just making great music, and his music is still great. I used it as meditation music for a long time, and it's amazing. It's really amazing. A friend of mine played the organ in a church, and when he played Bach, all emotions came free. Well, maybe that's what those dudes were afraid of and are afraid of nowadays with rock and roll, that kind of music has an effect on the body-mind structure that is able to set people free, at least for some minutes. And well, people that dream of an old world order don't like freedom, that's for sure. Enjoy yourself and enjoy life. Till soon.